you have granted to be your wedded husband, to live together after God's ordinance and holy marriage, for you love him, honor him, keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep yourself only unto him, so long as you both shall live. In 1 Corinthians 14, God gives us the example of what love is. He gives us a lovely picture. He says that love is patient, love is kind, love is not jealous, love doesn't sing its own praises, it isn't arrogant, it isn't rude, love doesn't think only of itself, it isn't irritable, it doesn't keep a record of wrongs, it isn't happy with injustice, but is happy with the truth. Love never stops being patient, never stops believing, never stops hoping, never gives up. Love never comes to an end. Brandy, as you take the love of Ashley, I charge you to love her as Christ loved the church, to be a spiritual leader in your home. You are called to walk alongside your wife and to lead by example, to show her love and compassion. Remember to listen to her and value her opinions, because they come from a heart of love. Ashley, as you take the love of Brandon, I charge you to honor him as the bride of Christ, to love him with a tender heart, speak honestly and always with encouragement, and reassure him with an undying devotion. Let him see the beauty which comes from deep within the heart of a woman who trusts in the Lord. Brandon, repeat after me. I, Brandon, take thee, Ashley, to be my wedded wife, to have and to hold, from this day forward, for better for worse, for richer for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, till death do we part. Ashley, repeat after me. I, Ashley, take thee, Brandon, to be my wedded husband, to have and to hold, from this day forward, for better for worse, for richer for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, till death do us part. Join me in prayer. Our Heavenly Father, we pray again. You will bless these two in their marriage. We pray that today that they will always remember the vows that they have made to one another, that they will always cherish and love each other and be supportive and strong in their family. Lord, all these we ask in Christ's name. Amen. Yeah, there is. These rings are an expression of the exchange of your marriage vows and a lasting symbol of the commitment to each other. You will place this ring on Ashley's finger and holding it in place, repeat after me. With this ring, I thee wed. With loyal love, I thee endow. With all my worldly goods, I share in the name of the Father, of the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. I ask if you would take Brandon's ring. Slide it on his left hand and hold it in place. Repeat after me. With this ring, I be wed. I be wed. With loyal love, I be endowed. And all my worldly goods I share. In the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Alright. In Mark chapter 10, Jesus quoted from Genesis on marriage. Jesus said, therefore a man shall leave his father and mother and hold fast to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh. So they are no longer two, but one. Brandon and Ashley will now mix two different sands, and the sands will become inseparable, signifying the oneness in their life together. a successful marriage is not determined by how much stuff you have, or how many children or grandchildren you have, or even how long you stay together. A successful marriage is one that grows stronger every day, walking hand in hand with each other in the footprints of Christ. As you seek to walk with God, your paths will grow closer, and your love ever stronger. By the authority given me as a minister of the gospel of Jesus Christ and the state of North Carolina, I now pronounce you husband and wife. What therefore God has come together, let no man set asunder. You may kiss your wife.